After several routing batches in winter and spring, I still had a few cuttings left in the fridge in early summer. Simply by wrapping them in kitchen film, they maintain inner moisture for long periods of time. Some of the cuttings were still fine, even after 3 or 4 months in the fridge. Others seemed a bit dehydrated, but I decided to try them anyway, as I had nothing to lose. Instead of scraping the bark near one of the last nodes, I made a single cut instead. It's faster and still very effective. I wrapped the upper parts of most of the cuttings in perfilm, so they could resist better the dehydration. Only half the cuttings were wrapped in the first batch, so I could compare the results. I like to make a fresh cut near the last node. The injured tissues near the cuts tend to develop roots faster. Applying rooting hormones to the fresh cuts can speed up the development of roots, so I tend to use them. But they are not essential to this rooting process. If you do use them, let them dry a bit before planting the cuttings. I have prepared a strip of soil to plant the cuttings. The best soils for this method are sandy and provide good drainage. Avoid heavy soils that keep too much moisture around the cuttings. When rooting in the summer, it's essential to shade the cuttings or they will dry out. I use freshly cut branches to provide shade. I also placed 2 strips of weed barrier fabric to reduce weed growth and to help maintain adequate moisture in the soil. Although not pleasing to the eye, the simplest way to keep the weed barrier in position is to cover it with something heavy. I tend to use ceramic roof tiles, as I have them readily available. After 4 to 6 weeks, some of the cuttings start to show a few leaves. After 2 months, I usually lift the branches to do some weeding and check the cuttings. Not all the cuttings will have the same development within the same rooting period. Variations are affected by the age of the cutting, cutting width, and fig variety. Don't remove the covering branches yet, or the young leaves might dry out under the sun. Depending on the soil type and the local temperatures, cuttings might need to be watered frequently at this stage. When the cuttings are approaching the 3-month mark, I tend to remove the covering branches. Most of the cuttings show several leaves at this stage and will benefit from more sun exposure. Remove most of the weeds to avoid competition. The weed barrier fabric does a good job keeping the weeds in control near the developing roots. This is the time to check for cuttings that have died and remove them. They will usually be soft to the touch and offer no resistance when gently pulled from the ground. Some cuttings might appear to have dried out. Even if they look dead, If they are not soft to the touch and resist removing, leave them, as they could still develop leaves. Some buds might be alive beneath the soil. When using longer cuttings with this method, don't forget that much of the cutting might still be alive, even if it looks dry above the soil. When space is limited, or I have too many cuttings to root, I might place them quite near to each other. To avoid competition, place them further apart when planting, or remove some of them to pots at this stage. Take care when removing cuttings and try to avoid damaging the young roots. Some cuttings might have several leaves and a very weak and underdeveloped rooting system. Although the cuttings have a good chance of surviving when potting up at this stage, I prefer to leave them a few more weeks in the ground. Avoid placing the new potted cuttings in full sun and don't overwater them. If you leave the cuttings in the ground and conditions are too harsh, leave a few branches to provide some shade. After 9 to 10 weeks, it's usually safe to remove all the branches. Beware that the cuttings that root slower might still have weak root systems. That might stress them when removing shade, and they will respond with falling leaves when trying to survive. In some cases, unable to absorb enough water from the young roots, the leaves might even dry out and the cutting might die. To avoid this problem, maintain some branches shading the less developed cuttings for as long as they need it. The difference in root development with just a few more weeks in the ground, can be decisive. Don't forget to label the pots to keep track of the rooted varieties. Leaving the cuttings in the ground until the end of the summer is also a good option, and the plants will be more robust when placed in pots. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe and share the video to support the channel. Hit the bell to receive notifications of new videos.